Peters. I'm the Chief Executive Officer of the Carter Center. First, I want to express my great appreciation to all of you for joining us, especially those of you who traveled from far away. Marie Plakos, the photographer behind the museum's special exhibition, Our Sister's Keeper, will spend a few minutes telling us about her experience capturing photos of women and children from four or five, not quite sure, countries around the world. Who is the artist and photographer behind the exhibition, Our Sister's Keeper? Today is the grand opening of that exhibition. As you'll see, it features 36 stunning images of women and children from India, Mexico, Ghana, and Peru. So Marie, would you please come up and talk to us about this wonderful exhibit?
You've got amazing, beautiful endurance in these women, and that really captured my heart because I knew that these are at-risk women and girls in these countries, and that human rights for them do not exist in many cases. No access to education, very inadequate health care, if any, physical abuse, early marriages, sex trafficking, it goes on and on. And I want to share a few staggering statistics that really keeps me going and going back and photographing and bringing beautiful images, but a message behind those, that being born a female is dangerous to your health. 160 million girls are missing from the face of the earth today because of sex selective abortions, which is called gendercide. And that happens greatly in China and in India particularly. 3 million girls a year are genitally mutilated, particularly in the African nations. 3 out of 4 war fatalities are women and girls and children. And we call this collateral damage. That's very sad. 77 million girls will never go to school. 1 out of 3 women worldwide and in the United States will experience violence at the hands of an intimate partner. That was staggering to me. And today, 16 million women and girls are victims of trafficking, either for sex or labor exploitation. Okay, so this is what the Forum on Women is addressing behind all of this. So they were statistics that I couldn't turn away from personally. And I thought, oh, my heart goes out to these women and these girls who are so talented and underappreciated and not being able to fully share in what life should offer. And so my collection of photography is about what I consider our sisters. I mean, we're all of the same feelings, the same behind who we are as people. And we're no different only in life circumstances. So I vowed in some way that I would do something about it, whatever I could do as an educator and as an artist. So that's how Our Sister's Keeper was born. It's the exchanges Marianne suggested. I sent President Carter my first book, Adornment, which talks about this beauty, but also gives some statistics and some background about the human rights issues. And he sent me back a call to action. So I spent a good couple of years putting together this project. There is a website called oursisterskeeper.org. And again, it's in full support of what's being done here at the Carter Center. So when you go through the exhibit, there are some stories, some commentary there that I think you will find interesting. I have put together a book And I am donating 100% of the proceeds from this book to the Forum on Women. So I hope you will go out and put your donation there to look at the exhibit and also buy the book. So just a quick little story, and it relates to Jacqueline's wonderful presentation, and it's about mental health. One of the exhibits I have is on the witch camp in Gambaga, Ghana, and you will see six images of women that are there. And it's a very sad thing that in the 21st century, women can be labeled as witches merely by the way a chicken lands when its throat is cut upside down or upright as to whether this woman is a witch, and then put away for life, so to speak, because of the stigma in a witch camp. And this is a reality today. So that's a big thing, that part of these women, I'm sure, have mental illness. And, you know, in West Africa, they don't really know how to treat mental illness except to label it as witchcraft or something, you know, that's of a traditional kind of labeling, because they don't know how to treat it. So if in the exhibit you will look at the back wall, you will see these images of the women from the witch camp. And I hope you will look at the exhibit not only with your eyes but with your heart, and realize that these women are real, that they have a face, they have a family, they have feelings, and they represent things that really need to be addressed worldwide, because it's a huge problem. Thank you very much.